also what's happening is K, we back in this 9K. So buddy, you sleep with a cutter up with Tron. No nigga want a Tron. Alright, we here to talk about some shit real quick. Now, this is not, like, I don't really have no news to report. Let me check, by the way. Oh, you see, I actually do have some shit to talk about in the report. No, it was a little slow of a day. There's nothing to talk about, really. So, we here to talk about, just have some conversations, you know what I'm saying? Just a little conversation, you dig, you hear me? Talk about bullshit, you know? Shoot the breeze. Now, sorry, I know I'm looking at this mostly as I am addressing y'all, but I'm just trying to make sure there's no news I am forgetting before I continue making my shit up. Well, not making my shit up, but continue talking like my ish. But anyways, we here. Also, before I get into it, RIP X and Jimmy Wapo, this is the day of their passing, the anniversary, so RIP both of them as well. All love and prayers to their families. You know what I'm saying? Time sometimes doesn't always make it get easier. It makes it get harder. But anyways, we here to talk about like couples and relationships in hip-hop. Do we care for the artist or do we care about the relationship? We have seen it with Shade Room that a lot of people will like, mostly women, because maybe they care about gossip or they love like Ari or Jada or fucking Sweetie. That, oh, what is their dude doing? They might not fuck with their music like that, but what is their dude doing? So they'll watch a Moneybagg Yo, or in the case of Ari, she also has a baby daddy, so they'll follow a G Herbo, they'll watch a fucking Quavo, a Lil Baby, and whoever else, such and such, as it fucking continues, right? Because of all this gossip and drama and everything that's happening. But do they really care? So at some point, we gotta ask yourself, what is making this artist lit? The relationship or the fucking thing? Now, we could say in the case of Travis Scott and Kylie Jenner, he has went up with his association with the Kardashians. He was already lit before. We're not going to deny this. And he was doing his thing. But I feel like his link up with Kylie made him grow a little bit. On the other side, we seen what happened with Tyga. Like, that nigga was going down, 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 down. Until he left the fucking Kim Kardashian clan and disappeared. And this nigga left that fucking plantation. This nigga came back to prominence a little bit. But in the case of Travis, him with Kylie is doing a little bit more. Of course, they have a kid, you know, everything going. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. And at one point, you got to ask yourself, yes, Travis Scott is late. He's an amazing artist. But is this relationship helping him? And that's what you got to ask. It got to the point on, I think it was Code Red. It was a joint tape with Moneybagg Yo and Black Youngsta. On one of the songs of Moneybagg Yo, it said featuring Ari, and then she was there. I think she was just talking or whatever the fuck. And then that was like one of the most streamed songs. So I'm just like, was that her fan base? Because he put her on a song. Was the song really that good? I just thought it was okay. Was it really that good? Like, what was going on? And I'm seeing stuff like that. So we can definitely see in the situation of Quavo and Sweetie that she grew exponentially with that fucking link up. With that link up from Quavo and the Migos and them doing their thing, she grew exponentially and did her thing. He helped her grow. He was way bigger artist. And that little association helped her grow a little bit. That's why there's such things as fake relationships. I think it came out at a point, Little Zan and Miley Cyrus's sister, what's her name, Noah Cyrus or something like that. She has a singing career. And it got to the point, they were trying to put them together for them to grow and get like share a fan base and do all this fake couple shit as marketing. And it's like, at some point, this shit is a business at some point. We get it. It's a music business. You're trying to do that. It is what it is. Shit. We even seen on fucking Hannah Montana, since I brought it up, there was some bullshit where she had to fake a relationship with some dude. She had to fake a relationship with some dude in order for them to sell albums and shit and look cute or whatever the fuck. It was what it was. And this is no different to this day. Now, the fact we are still relying on some of this old ass shit in the age of the internet, and a nigga could literally just come sit on his front porch with a gun and make a music video and just have the gun pointing at the camera and get 2 million views, it behooves me why the fucking labels just be moving sloppy and old. But hey, I digress. So we gotta get to the point. Do we love the artist or do we love the fucking relationship? Now, me personally, I like a lot of these artists I have mentioned. Well, Tyga, he fell off, he came back. But But baby been my nigga. I've been fucking with Moneybagg Yo since he dropped yesterday with Dirk. Before Dirk was scorching like this. Fucking Migos is Migos. Come on, everybody fuck with Migos in my opinion. I've not met a person that did not like a song from the Migos, to be honest. And then yeah, who else I mentioned? And so well, I guess Quavo. Yeah, whatever. I'll group him in with the Migos. Fuck it. Yeah, and yeah. It's been a while now. There's other couples as well that are, and Travis is Travis. Kylie did, I guess, blow him up a little bit. She has a huge following. He has a big following as well. But she's in a different market, and that's the thing, though. She's kind of into reality TV, cosmetics, like kind of IG model type shit, and this nigga in music. So I feel like some of her shit transferred over to him. And plus, you have all these fucking Kardashians previewing your album and telling people to check it out. It drops this day. I'm pretty sure that will help your sales. I'm not gonna lie about that. You know what I'm saying? But it is what it is. We've seen it a lot of the time, like with the Amber Rose and the 21 when that was happening, and various other relationships that were going on. And that's what we have to ask yourself. Now, this is an open-ended question. I'm not here. I'm a dude, though. This is the thing, right? And I love hip-hop music. That's mostly what my channel's about. So I follow a lot of these artists. So for me, I'm going to sit here and just off-rip like, yo, the music is why I follow such and such. But maybe if you're a female viewer, you might sit here like, I don't really know of this dude, but I know I love Ari, or I love Jada. I think that's fucking couple goals, or I just love her. So you're linked with her, so I went to go check out your stuff. You know what I'm saying? And yes, some people are like that. So I'm not going to sit here and deny that that could also be a factor in somebody buying your fucking album. No. So we also got to sit here and put that into thing. When Chris Brown was with fucking Karrueche, who knows? She's a model. Who knows? Like, oh, you, that's your nigga? Oh, cool. I'm going to go check him out. Yeah, he's a handsome dude. He make music. Now, I feel like everybody and their mama know Chris Brown. So that's a bad example. But, like, yeah, I feel like some of these link-ups, you know, yes, they might actually genuinely care for each other, but it also helps them. It fucking also helps them. Like Safari and Nick. Nick helps Safari way more than Safari could help Nicki. She did? No, Safari already committed. I don't know what the fuck going on with that situation. I'm just confused. Like, it is what it is. It is what it is. It might change your perception. Like, oh, Meek and Nicki, when Meek and Nicki were together. Look at what his album did. Now, the Barbs, anything Nicki supports or anything Nicki is on in general, they will go crazy. But it helped him. Because I remember, that was the album he sold the most, I think, until Championships came out and he got the Drake feature. And then he sold around that or even above what he did with Dreams Worth More Than Money. But it was what it was. Now, I didn't personally like Dreams Worth More Than Money. It was too, like, cutesy and shit. Like, shit. There was a couple songs I was fucking with, but I'm like, nah, I'm good off this shit. Wins and Losses was more my type of sound than the Dream Chaser mixtapes. But it was what it was. She did help him. It did benefit him. I feel like he didn't benefit her being with her as much. Because Wayne. Because Nick could have just been running around with Lil Wayne and Drake. And she would have been fucking fine. The fucking Young Money trilogy. The Young Money trilogy is fine. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is. It's the Young Money trilogy and Tyga. That's how I view it. It's like them three, and then we have Tyga. Tyga chilling. But it is what it is. Honestly, it's a good time. It really is a good time. And it's a valid question, in my opinion. I feel like it is a valid question. Because some people might prioritize the music more. Some people might prioritize the relationship, or maybe the antics, or what they get into. What? I love Pooh Shiesty, you know, the song is hard, but when I know he a real stepper, it works more compared to with the Pop Hunter situation. I'm just like, hey, bro, you was doing your shit. Like, again, I understand, but, like, it ain't gonna help your rap career if you coming off as a real stepper. Which, if you actually listen to the song and stop doing the Corvette, Corvette, and stop listening to that part, if you actually listen to some of the shit that nigga be saying, it's like, oh, no, you a stepper, my nigga. You saying you gonna do what to a nigga? Like, you street nigga, I didn't. Like, yeah. So, it is what it is. At the end of the day. Shit, Ruby fucking Rose and DDG, that's another Maybe that's fucking why she got on the XXL list. Not to say she doesn't put in work, but I feel like this year, in general, she has not done that much to be here. I feel like next year, if you put her on, cool. But this year, particularly, I'm just like, well, why is she here? Well, maybe that link up and all this shit going on with TJ, we're paying attention, she's dropping the music, she's doing whatever. Maybe that's it. Maybe that's it. I'm surprised Sweetie ain't on that motherfucker, but maybe she turned it on. Anyways, enough about the double XL list. But yeah, what do you think about that? Is the relationship a factor in a person's like popularity and success? Or are you just there for the music? Talk to me. Talk to me. Come in the comments. Talk to me a little bit. What's up? Say your name. I'll say hi back. You hear me? But anyways, I'm off of this shit. You already know what it is. Like, subscribe. Help your boy out. Help your boy grow. I forgot to do my little spiel in the beginning, so I'm doing it now. So if you get to the end, you heard this thing, and I appreciate you. But we gone. We gone. And I'll see you tomorrow. Or tomorrow, or the next day after that, or the next day after that. Hey, depending whenever I could get other shit and get my life together. That was a trash ass ending. But I'm gone. Shalom, zoom, peace, y'all. Elsh gang. I.